We've been receiving a lot of inbound inquiry lately about our company and about our engines as well too. We've decided to generate a short series of videos to answer those frequently asked questions. We've been receiving a lot of questions about whether our engine can fit into individuals' airframes. In this video, I'll be talking through both the fixed wing and rotary wing applications for our engine. I'd like to start off by saying that generically, if you've got something like an 0320 or an 0360 in your aircraft, that it's highly likely that our engine will be able to go in there as well too. There are some considerations, however. Weight and balance is one of those. Our engine is going to weigh a little bit less than an 0320 and a fair bit less than an 0360. You're going to have to take that into consideration when considering this engine for your airframe. There are various other considerations as well too. As an example, the fuel system is one. You'll find that with a piston engine, that when you change tanks, when one is running low, that the engine may splutter and pick up in a piston engine. In a turbine engine, it's imperative that the flame keeps burning in the combustor. Unlike a piston engine where a spark plug ignites it on every rotation, a turbine is constantly burning. If there's any fuel flow interruption to the combustor, the flame goes out, the engine stops, and you've got to do a relight on the engine. So you're going to have considerations in relation to weight. You're going to have considerations in relation to your fuel system as well too. But that said, we're going to be working with companies to develop firewall forward packages, which will include all the considerations that are required to install this engine into your airframe. One of the benefits of our engine is that it can be used in either tractor or pusher configuration. We've designed it as such so that it can be used in any orientation. From that perspective, it can be used in pretty well any airframe that utilises an 0320 or 0360 or similar engine. The RV series of aircraft is going to be a very popular one for our engine. In particular, the tandem models such as the RV4 and the RV8 are going to appreciate the narrow width of our engine. It'll fit very, very nicely into their single width fuselage. Other popular aircraft are the legacy Lanciers, such as the Lancier 320, Lancier 360, which will appreciate our engine. Other legacy aircraft, such as the Glacier, will also appreciate a change to our engine. One of the more modern designs is the Dark Aero, and we're finding that's very popular amongst our customer base. Our engine's going to be perfect for that, in that they're going to be able to streamline that cowling even more than it is now, and get better performance out of that airframe than they would with the piston engine in it. Because it can be used in pusher configuration, it's also going to be ideal for airframes such as the Velocity and some of the Easy airframes. The low and slow, or STOL aircraft also, will find it very popular. We've had a great deal of inquiry from customers of Cub Crafters, American Legend, Patriot aircraft, those types, where they see the benefits of the lighter weight. The other sector where our engine has proven to be very popular is with the helicopters. The likes of Safari, Mosquito Swift, Rotaway, and Helicycle would benefit significantly from the reduced weight of our engine over the IO360 that are fitted to some of those. I guess finally, I should give our own airframe a bit of a plug, the Arion Lightning. That's going to be the test bed for our engine moving ahead. We're very excited to be getting the engine onto this in the not too distant future. As well as the experimental aircraft, we're also intending in due course to undertake certification of our engine to allow it to go into certificated aircraft. We're getting a great deal of inquiry about this engine to go into airframes such as the Mooney, because we all know that Mooney owners are very keen on speed and efficiency, but also a great deal of inquiry from legacy Cessna and Piper owners. Now, of course, the certification process itself for our engine is going to take time, and we're estimating a few years for that. But also, to install it into your certificated aircraft, there will be a requirement for a supplementary type certificate to be developed to allow the incorporation of our engine into the airframe. The good news is that we have had a lot of inquiry from companies or individuals that are wanting to develop STCs for the more popular airframes. So the Piper 140, Piper 180, Archers, the Cessna 172s that use the IO360s, there's a great deal of interest to develop STCs for that legacy fleet. Of course, we'll be working with the airframe manufacturers to get our engine into new aircraft as well too. So hopefully down track, a new Mooney, a new Cessna, a new Piper, a new Cirrus may all see our engine installed in it. I hope I've answered all your questions about whether this engine can be installed in your aircraft, but if not, please drop it in the comments section below. In order to ensure you don't miss any of our frequently asked questions series, please refer to our playlist. I'm Dave Limmer, and as always, safe flying.